Tonight, the Social Security Administration is one step closer to having a new leader, just as it is plagued with trying to collect billions of dollars in overpayments, something 11 investigates has exposed. The Senate Finance Committee is considering President Biden's nominee for commissioner, former Maryland Governor Martin O'Malley. Our Amy Hudak is live now in the studio. And Amy, this confirmation hearing comes at a time when the Social Security Administration is at a tipping point.
Yes, Susan, the agency is crippled by understaffing, low morale, and those billions of dollars in overpayments the government is trying to claw back. If confirmed, O'Malley will have a huge task on his hands.
As I've read those stories about people in danger of losing their homes or other financial catastrophes, it's heartbreaking.
During a Senate Finance Committee hearing for his confirmation, former Maryland Governor Martin O'Malley was asked directly about the $21 billion in overpayments the agency made an error and now wants back, something Channel 11 has been investigating for months.
Overpayments push already struggling beneficiaries even deeper into poverty and hardship, which is directly counterproductive to the goals of the program.
Senators Bob Casey from Pennsylvania, along with Senators Wyden and Brown, sent this letter to the agency last month asking why these overpayments are happening. Senator Brown asked O'Malley about the asset limit that hasn't been updated in 40 years.
Am I correct in understanding this outdated asset limit is in fact the leading cause of overpayments?
It's a leading cause, and it's a huge administrative burden.
COVID-19 stimulus checks even bumping some folks above the asset limit. Senator Casey, who's on the Senate Finance Committee, talked to us after the hearing.
These are situations where someone received a COVID-19 payment and therefore had their SSI benefits reduced. We need to correct that.
Senators Wyden, Brown, and Cassidy introduced bipartisan legislation called the SSI Savings Penalty Elimination Act to raise that asset limit. Senator Casey was an original Senate co-sponsor. O'Malley saying there's a widespread belief that that would be the right thing to do for recipients and to reduce the burden on the agency.
I think he's going to be confirmed. I'd be surprised if he's not. We can work more directly with him to correct this problem, to reinstate those benefits.
Senator Casey called Martin O'Malley a skilled and capable manager who will lead the agency and invest in its future. Lisa.